But it's not all beer and skittles being a champion. There's more to it than just putting on the gear and walking onto the pitch to the roar of the crowd. These men are fit to be champions. Their bodies are tuned and ready for the demands made upon them. The champagne stories belong in the press. This is the reality.
Hello, Phil.
Hello there.
Have you got time for a quick question?
Yes, sure, I've got a minute.
We'd like to ask you, what are your ideas on training for fitness?
Well, I think a very good thing is plenty of exercise. Everybody must get exercise to get out there and get their heart pumping. Well, it makes you really feel good, I think, especially at the end of it. But another thing is a very good diet. I think if people can eat the right foods, that's a very good thing. And then, of course, with the beer, I think you've got to maybe cut out the beer a bit. You've got to drink beer in moderation, I think. But the thing that everybody, I think, must cut out is smoking. Smoking is very bad for you. And they try and stress it at our club not to smoke, and which none of our players do. But they try and keep us out of the way of smoke, especially on match days. Anyway, I've got to go now. Okay?
Thanks a lot.
Not everyone has the ability or the desire to be a sporting star. Yet isn't it odd that although we expect a car to last no more than 10 years, and then only with proper maintenance and repair, we expect our personal vehicle, the body, to last 70 years through all kinds of neglect and abuse.